मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल डिस्कस सेक्शन 47 एंड सेक्शन 48 ऑफ द पेटेंट्स एक्ट 1970। सेक्शन 47 हैज द टाइटल ग्रांट ऑफ पेटेंट्स टू बी सब्जेक्ट टू सर्टन कंडीशंस एंड दिस सिंपली मीन्स दैट पेटेंट्स आर ग्रांटेड अंडर सर्टन कंडीशंस। वी विल प्रोसीड। की पॉइंट्स आर द ग्रांट ऑफ पेटेंट अंडर दिस एक्ट शैल बी सब्जेक्ट टू the conditions, and the conditions here are given under the subsection. So subsection 1 or condition 1 is any machine, apparatus or other article for which the patent is granted, or any article made by using a process in respect of which the patent is granted, may be imported or made by or on behalf of the government for the purpose merely of its own use. This simply means that product patents or process patents may be imported or made by or on behalf of the government. On behalf of the government means the departments under government for the purpose merely of its own use. And we can say merely of its own use means not certainly but normally for public welfare. Fine. So here the underlined words machine, apparatus and other article comes under the category of products, and here article made by using a process comes under process. So these are the first one is for product patents and the second one is for process patents. And so we can say that this subsection 1 emphasizes on product patents or products made by a patented process or process patents. Fine. Subsection 2. Any process with respect to which the patent is granted may be used by or on behalf of the government for the purpose merely of its own use. This emphasizes on process patents only here. Fine. Also, you can, when you compare between subsection 1 and 2, you see in subsection 1, imported or made where given or considered in the subsection 1, but here in subsection 2 only it is given as may be used by. Fine. So just for knowledge I have told this. Then we will go to subsection 3. Listen carefully. Any machine, apparatus or other article in respect of which the patent is granted, or any article made by the use of the process in respect of which the patent is granted, may be made or used, and any process in respect of which the patent is granted may be used by any person for the purpose merely of experiment or research, including the imparting of instructions to pupils, semicolon, and subsection 4 we will read later. First I will explain you subsection 3. So when you keep a deep look, when you take a deep look into subsection 3, you will find that here for the purpose of government or on behalf of the government for the purpose merely of its own use kind of phrases you will not find here. What you will find? You will find here the term by any person and for the purpose merely of experiment or research. So the key point here is it can be, or we can say any person is eligible, but for the purpose should be for experiment or research only, or instructions to the pupils are also allowed. So I have made a note here for subsection 3. Just take a look. Subsection 3 is a combination of subsection 1 and subsection 2 of section 47. Next point. This subsection can be considered for research exemption, as I told earlier. Made or used only for experiment or research purpose. Should not follow commercial purpose at all. That means you cannot make money out of it. Next. Instructions to pupil or classroom learning is allowed. What I have mentioned here. Next, go to subsection 4. In the case of a patent in respect of any medicine or drug which are imported by the government for its own use or for distribution in a dispensary, hospital, or other medical institutions maintained by or this slash are given for or on behalf of the government or dispensary or hospital or other medical institutions which the central government specify regarding this by notification in the official gazette. And this specification is normally done for the public welfare purpose, public service purpose. Fine. So this lengthy subsection can be explained in short like patents related to health benefits, that is drug or medicine patents, and these are specified in the official gazette by the central government. And this thing, the main thing here is that this drug or medicine patents can be imported by the government for its own use or for distribution in the medical or health organization such as dispensary, hospital, etc. Fine. This way section 47 is completed. We will proceed towards section 48. Section 48 has the title Right of Patentees. So who is a patentee? A patentee is the patent holder, we can say. The key points: subject to the other provisions contained in this act and the conditions specified in section 47, a patent granted under this act shall confer upon the patentee. Now this whole thing has the simple meaning, that is the patentee has the below rights. These are explained in bit A and bit B. Bit A says, for a product patent, if the patentee has no consent, third parties cannot make use, offer for sell or import for those purposes in India. And this is meant for that product. Fine. Bit B says, for a process patent, if the patentee has no consent, third parties cannot use the process, use, offer for sell or import for those purposes in India. And this is meant for the product directly obtained by that process. Okay. Next. Simply we can note some important things here from section 47 and 48. Section 47 deals with importing, and that means imports, and section 48 deals with exporting or selling or exports. So this is the simple difference between these two. So this way section 47 and 48 both are completed. And this much is for today, and I will tell you the same thing which I forgot actually in the starting of the video. Please go through the BARE Act also while going through this video, and please comment in the comment box, and please share among your friends this video so that everyone will be benefited, and please subscribe my channel with pressing the bell icon. Thank you.